Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, Jennifer Marievo, where I teach you different ways that you can make money online working from home. So a lot of my tutorials focus on working as a freelancer, and if you become a freelancer, you will eventually get clients, and you'll probably be having them pay you via PayPal. So a lot of times what you have to do is create an invoice to send directly to your client for them to pay in advance before you do the work. Whenever I do voiceover or video editing work, I always send an invoice and have that paid first. It's a way to protect me. This is if I'm doing a job outside of a freelancing platform. But I have some clients that find me and they find me on YouTube or they find my website and then they reach out to me saying that they want me to do a video or a tutorial or a voiceover for them. And this is what I do to create an invoice. So once you log into your PayPal account, you can see here at the top we have quick links and you can click on either invoicing or request money. If you want to send money to someone, you could press send money. Or you can go to pay and get paid. So let's just click on that tab here. And then here under invoicing, you can go to create and manage invoices. So we're going to click on that. And this will bring up manage invoices. And here you can see, you know, this is a list of all the different invoices that I have sent out. You can see if they've been paid and the amount as well. To create an invoice, just click create invoice and then invoice. And that will bring up this form here. So first of all, you have a little spot where you can put your logo. So for example, I'm going to click remove. And here you can see it says add company logo. You don't have to choose one, but if you want to make your invoice look more professional, I definitely recommend you click Add Company Logo. Then just locate your logo on your computer. I will be creating a tutorial teaching you how to create logos shortly. Here there's a tab that you could edit your business information if you want to add your phone number or something like that or your website, but you also don't have to add that information as well. On the side, you can set the frequency. So let's say this is going to be a recurring invoice. Let's say someone is hiring you to do social media management and you're going to be running their social media on their Facebook page or Instagram. You could choose every month. And then you can see here, it says, when you click start series, we'll send an invoice every month until you cancel. Usually I do one-off invoices because my clients will hire me to do a voiceover or create a video, so I'm just going to click once only. Here you can set the invoice number and also the invoice date. You can select any invoice date. This invoice will be sent today or on a future date that you choose. And then here under due date, you can set when they have to pay the invoice. So you could put no due date, due on receipt, due in 10 days, due on date specified, and then select the date that you want it to be paid by. I'm just going to click due on receipt. And then here you can put in your bill to, so an email address or a name. So put here the email address that you want to send the invoice to. If you do not have a specific email address, I'm also going to show you how you can create an invoice link and you can share that link to your client and then they can click on the link and pay it directly in PayPal. But for this, let's just put joeblack@gmail.com. So here we have the customize section and you can put here different details like quantity, hours, or amount only. There's also a space if you want to add tax, a detailed description. So let's say for example, I'm going to create an invoice for a voiceover that I'm doing for someone. So let's say commercial voiceover, 2 minutes. And let's say it's one voiceover and I'm charging $120. You could also click save item if you want to use this item again in future. And then you might also want to add in a second item. So let's say I'm going to do two different projects for this client. I could put, say a radio voiceover, 30 seconds. Let's say I'm charging $90. And you can see here that they have the total would be $210. And you can add as many different items as you want. Or if you want to erase them, you just click on the X here and that will erase the item. Here you have an option to allow for partial payment. So your customer will be allowed to enter any payment amount above the minimum until the invoice is paid in full. So let's say I'm going to let my client start paying, you know, and instead of them paying $210 all at once, they can pay $50 and then, you know, keep paying until the invoice is paid in full. And then I also have the option to allow the customer to add a tip. So if they were really happy with my job and I enable this, there's an option for them to give me a bit of extra money. Usually I don't enable this, but you can if you want. And then here there's a note to the recipient. So you could say, thank you for your business. And then you could also put in your terms and conditions. So for example, I might put voiceovers include one voiceover plus one round of revisions. Here you have an option to attach any files that you might need to attach. And then there's also an option for you to add a memo to yourself so your recipient won't see this. So maybe you want to make some note about the client. And then here you can preview the invoice. You can send the invoice or save it as a draft or as a template. So let's click preview. And you can see here that this is what the invoice will look like. Because we've given them an option to add a tip, they could add that here if they wanted to add a percentage. And then you can see here the description. We have our logo, our name, we've got the date, the amount due, and we have who it's billed to and the description. And if you're not happy with this, you can choose edit. So let's say I'm going to take off the tip part and I'm going to click allow partial payment. I want them to pay at least $100. Let's go preview. And you can see here that now when the client will receive this, they have the option to pay $210 right away or pay the minimum amount of $100 or pay whatever amount they want. So now when you want to send the invoice, you have two different options. You can click send, send via PayPal, and that will send this invoice directly to this email here. Or let's say you don't know the name of the person. Sometimes I do work for clients and they have multiple different people on their team. And so one person wants me to send an invoice, but then they will send that invoice to another person who pays it. So I usually like to share the link myself. So if I click share link myself, it says copy and share the invoice link through email, text, or chat. Clicking copy will update the status to unpaid. So once I click copy, this invoice has now been created. And now you can see that all of these other invoices that I've sent out previously have been paid. And this one here is unpaid and you can see the due date. So now you can go ahead and copy and paste this link in your email if you haven't sent it directly through PayPal. And then when your client opens it up, they will get this invoice here that's through PayPal, so they know it's secure and they can go ahead and use their credit card or their PayPal balance to pay the amount. And this is what the invoice will look like. So once you send out your invoice, your client will receive something like this asking them to pay their invoice and they can go ahead and view and pay the invoice that you have created. Now the other option that you have for requesting money, let's say you went out for dinner with a friend and they owe you $20 and you want them to send you the money via PayPal, you don't have to create an invoice for that. You can just click on request money under quick links when you log into your PayPal account. So here under request, you can request money from anyone. So all you would have to do is type in the email. So let's say I wanted to request money from my friend, then just type in their email and click request from, and you can add in as many people as you want, and then click next, and then just put in the amount of money that you want them to pay you. So for example, you can put in your currency here. So let's say I want my friend to send me 20 euro and you can add a note, then choose request money. And then it will say you requested however much money from, and then the email, and that will be sent to them. So it's just that easy to create and send invoices. And this is an important skill for you to have when you start working as a freelancer and clients start reaching out to you to have you do work for them. So thanks again for watching. Make sure to subscribe for more videos like this one on how to become a freelancer and eventually working your way to earning a full-time income working from home. Thanks again for watching and I'll see you in my next tutorial.